In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use the increment function inside IntegroMod, and I also want to show you some examples of what you could actually use it for. So let's just dive right in. So to add the increment function to your scenario, super duper easy, we just add a new module, and then inside the search bar, we type increment, and over here you find the tools modules, and then here under actions you find the increment function, and then there's already a little explanation underneath that. It says that it returns a value of 1. After the first run, and then every subsequent run, it will increment the returned value by 1. So it's going to generate a value, and after the first run, the value will be 1. If the scenario runs for the 12th time, for example, then the value is going to be 12. So we just add this over here, and then it also asks us when we would like to reset that value. So usually I set this to never, but it obviously depends on what you want to do with it. But you can, for example, also reset that value after one scenario execution. So then after one scenario execution, then the next one is going to be 1 again. And then you can also do it after one cycle if you want. But usually I stick to never, that's how I use it most often, but hey, the other options are there if you need them. So then I click here, okay, and then I click save, and then I can also show you here. So we run this once, the secure scenario has been executed one time, right? So then here, the value of the increment function, which here they depict as I, is 1. So then if I run it once again, then you see that the value right now is 2, run it again, the value is 3, run it again, value is 4, and so on, and so on, and so on. And this is really handy for a couple of reasons. So let me just show you some cool examples. So the first example I want to show you is this one over here. So over here, we have a Google Sheet module, and this one is going to watch for new rows inside this Google Sheet with leads. And what I thought is maybe cool is that we have this list of leads, and then we automatically want to divide these new leads between two sales representatives. So what we did over here is after the starting module over here, we have the increment function. So again, the first time it will run, it will generate 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. And then we can go into a router, and after the router, we have two filters. So we have two routes, and only when the condition in this filter is a match, only then will the bundle of data continue through that route. So what I thought is cool is that we can just check if the value of the increment function is odd or even. And then if it's odd, it's going over here, and then we send the lead info to Ben, for example, and then we update a row inside our Google Sheet. And then what I wanted to do is I wanted to update this column over here with the sales rep with who is taking care of that lead. So then over here you can see that I said, okay, update the row, row number. And then here I just mapped the value from that we got over here. And then if we scroll down, then you see over here that I update the sales rep to Ben. And then if it is even, we go down here and we send the lead info to Vera, and then we also update the Google Sheet, and then we set that same thing to Vera. So you can see that also over here, but how do we do that? So over here we have odd, and here we have even. Now it's actually pretty easy. So here we have odd, and we just check if the increment function value basically, and then the we use over here the modulus you can find under the math functions, and over here you see mod, this is the modulus, and then 2, and then we just check if that is equal to 1, because if this is equal to 1, then we know it's an odd number. And over here you can see if it's equal to 0, then we know it's an even number. So if I click here, win once, then it's going to watch for new rows. It found a new row in this case because I already added a bunch of sample data to it. Then over here, you see that the increment function value is 1 over here. And then it went through this path in our router because the filter over here is a match. It is an odd number. It's not an even number. So it did not go down here. So the lead info went to Ben. And if we go over to our list of leads, then you see here, this is now updated with Ben. If I now click here, win once again, it's going to watch for a row. Then here, increment function will be 2. This time it's an even number. You can also see this little 1 here below this filter, and also here this check mark. So it is an even number. So the filter over here was a match. We send the lead info to Vera, and we updated the Google Sheet. So over here now you see that it says Vera. So I think this is like a pretty cool use case of the increment function. Just every scenario, execution, every scenario run is going to divide them between Ben and Vera. Pretty cool, right? So then the second example I want to show you is this one over here. So I call this the coupon distributor. So over here I have a Google Sheet again with, in this case, coupons. And then over here you see, for example, what the coupon is for, how much discount they get for it, the coupon code itself, until when it's valid, if it has been distributed, and if it has been claimed. So what I want to do is I automatically, when I send, the next one and the next coupon and the next coupon and the next coupon. So for that, I also use the increment function. This one is going to generate a number, and then I'm going to get that coupon data. I'll also show you this in a bit, depending on that number. So if the increment function is 4, it's going to get row number 4. It's actually pretty simple to do it this way. So let me demonstrate this. So here we click run once. Then over here we have a webhook, and this webhook will be triggered in ActiveCampaign whenever somebody is subscribing to the newsletter. You can also use different tools for that, but that's just what I'm using. So let me quickly do that over here. And then you see that the webhook is going to get some data over here. This is the data that we got, the contact data. Here you see Emma Doe, first name, last name. Then the increment function value in this case is 5. So before this, I already tested it 4 times. So this is the 5th time. So the value of the increment function is 5. Then what I did over here is I checked if the value of the increment function is 101 or less. So you can see over here, I checked if I, so the increment function value, is greater than or equal to 2, and the increment function value is less than or equal to 101. Now, why did I do that? So I basically check if the number is 2 or between 2 and 101. So I did that because over here inside the sheet, you can see that I added 100 coupons, and the first row inside this Google Sheet is for the headers, like this one over here. So that's why I checked that over there. So after 101 or 100 coupons have been distributed, it will also not continue through that filter, because then the value of the increment function is going to be higher than what I specified in this filter over here. Now then we're going to get the coupon data. You can see over here how I did that. So over here you see that I selected the spreadsheet, the list of coupons, then the sheet inside it, newsletter coupons, and then here we get the range A till F. And then over here we have the increment function value, right? So over here it says 5. So then in this case, for example, it's going to get A5, here A5 till F5. So then in this case, it got this over here. So this is A5 till F5. So that is this over here. And then what I did is, so we get that data, then we quickly check if that has not been distributed yet, because inside the spreadsheet over here, we have these checkboxes, right? So I'm checking if the value is true or false, and it should be false. So what I do over here is I check if E is equal to false. So over here, E false, then over here, I check E is equal to false, and now, so this is over here, under the date and time functions, the now variable, and I'm quickly checking if now is earlier than D. And you can see over here, D is a date. And if we go over here, that is until when the coupon is valid. Pretty cool, right? So then, if the coupon has not been distributed yet and it's still valid, then it's going to send a coupon. And then over here, you can see that the email was sent to Emma Doe. So that's the data we got over here, right? And then we say over here, hey Emma, from now on I will send you a magical story every Tuesday. In the meanwhile, you can use coupon, and then you see here W1L71 etc. to claim your 10% discount in our magic store. It's valid until the 31st of December 2021. Kind regards, your magic shop. So that's also all the data that we got over here, and we just reuse that inside that email. So over here you can also see how that works. In the meanwhile, you can use coupon, and then over here you see that we get C, B, D over here, and then we set distributed to true. So we update a cell over here. You can also see how I did that inside the module settings. So here you see that we updated cell E, then 5 in this case, and we set the value to true. So now you see over here that this checkbox is ticked. So if we do the same thing again, then you can also see that it's going to do it exactly the same again, but this time the increment function value is going to be 6. Then it will pass through the filter because it is between 2 and 101. Then we get the coupon data, then it continued because the coupon has not been distributed yet and now is before the expiry date. Then we send the coupon, we send the coupon over here, and then we set distributed to true. And then now over here you see that row 6 is true. So I hope this helped you to understand how the increment function works and also what you can use it for. And if you want to learn more of these cool tricks, I also created a cool Integromat cheat sheet, which you can find below this video in the description. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below.